Trachoma is also known as Egyptian ophthalmia, is a chronic keratoconjunctivitis. It is characterized by both follicular and papillary response of conjunctiva. It is a leading cause of preventable blindness in the world. The causative organism is Chlamydia trachomatis, which is a gram-negative obligate intracellular bacteria. The serotypes associated are A, B, BA and C, in which C is most commonly associated. The source of infection is conjunctival discharge of an affected person, and the transmission is through flies, fomites and fingers. Coming to the clinical features of trachoma, it can be described in two phases, that is phase of active trachoma and phase of cicatrical trachoma. First we will see of active trachoma. In this stage, there is active chlamydial infection. The symptoms are determined by the presence or absence of secondary infection. In the absence of secondary infection, it is pure trachoma, and there is symptoms like mild foreign body sensation, occasional lacrimation, slight stickiness of the lids and scanty mucoid discharge. With secondary bacterial infection, it will be presenting as acute mucopurulent conjunctivitis. The signs in active trachoma can be divided as conjunctival signs and corneal signs. Coming to the conjunctival signs, they are: there may be formation of congestion. It is more prominent in the upper tarsal and the fornicial conjunctiva. There is formation of follicles due to the hyperplasia of lymphoid tissue. It will be having a characteristic boiled sago grains appearance. The follicles are more prominent in the upper tarsal conjunctiva. On histopathological examination, there is presence of characteristic multinucleated giant cells known as Leber cells. They contain intracytoplasmic inclusions called HP bodies or Halberstadter Provosac bodies. Presence of Leber cells and necrosis will help to differentiate the trachoma follicles from the follicles of other forms of follicular conjunctivitis. There is papillary reaction due to the epithelial hyperplasia. The upper tarsal conjunctiva will be having a red velvety appearance. Coming to the corneal signs, there may be superficial keratitis present in the upper part. Hebert follicles are typical follicles present in the limbal area. These are pathognomic for the trachoma. There is pannus formation. This is due to the infiltration of cornea with vascularization. The vessels will lie between the epithelium and the Bowman's membrane. In case of active trachoma, the pannus is progressive in nature. That is, the infiltration of cornea is ahead of vascularization. In the advanced stage, there may be formation of corneal ulcer. The picture shows boiled sago grain appearance of the follicles. Coming to the cicatrical phase of trachoma, it is more commonly seen in the middle age. There is continued mild grade of chronic inflammation. The characteristic linear scar present in the sulcus subtarsalis is called as Ard's line. This picture shows the Ard's line in the upper conjunctiva. Concretions are whitish deposit due to the accumulation of dead epithelial cells and inpicated mucus in the depressions called glands of Henle. These are not calcareous deposits. In case of cicatrical trachoma, the pannus is regressive in nature. In this, the vascularization is ahead of infiltration. Characteristic oval or circular pitted scars left after the healing of Herbert follicles in the limbal area are called as Herbert pits. The arrow shows Herbert pits in the limbal area. Corneal opacity may be present in the upper part. It may even extend down and involve the papillary area. The lead signs are trichiasis, entropion, tylosis, madarosis, and ankyloblepharon. Next, we will see the grading of trachoma. According to McCallan's classification, the trachoma is being divided into four stages. The stage 1 is known as the incipient trachoma, which is characterized by the hyperemia of the conjunctiva and immature follicles. The stage 2 is established trachoma, which is having mature follicles, papillae, and a progressive corneal pannus. Stage 3 is the cicatrizing trachoma, which is having an obvious scar. The stage 4 is the healed trachoma or the stage of sequelae. In this, the disease is quite and cured, but the sequelae is due to the cicatrization giving rise to the symptoms. Next, we will see the WHO classification. It is being classified into 5 stages. The first one is TF, that is trachomatous inflammation follicular. It is having predominantly follicular inflammation. This stage is diagnosed by the presence of at least 5 or more follicles and each having 0.5 millimeter or more in diameter. The next stage is TI, which is trachomatous inflammation intense. This is having an intense inflammatory response. The next is TS, that is trachomatous scarring, which is having a scar in the tarsal conjunctiva. The fourth stage is TT, that is trachomatous trichiasis. This is being diagnosed by the presence of at least one eyelash rubbing over the eyeball. Evidence of recent removal of the eyelashes is also being graded as trachomatous trichiasis stage. The fifth stage is CO, that is corneal opacity. Next, we will see what is the complication of trachoma. The only complication of trachoma is corneal ulcer. This can lead into the formation of scar, which will cause visual impairment. Coming to the diagnosis of trachoma, clinically, it is diagnosed from the signs. Laboratory diagnosis can be made by different methods. Conjunctival cytology showing presence of plasma cells and Leber cells are suggestive of trachoma. Detection of inclusion bodies in the conjunctival smear by Jamieson stain or iodine stain are also suggestive of trachoma. The serotyping is done by microimmunofluorescence. ELISA and PCR can also be used for the diagnosis. Next, we will see the differential diagnosis. The first one is acute adenoviral follicular conjunctivitis. In case of trachoma, the follicles are more distributed in the upper tarsal and the fornicial conjunctiva, and there is presence of papillae and pannus. These features helps to differentiate trachoma from the acute adenoviral follicular conjunctivitis. The next one is spring catarrh. In case of spring catarrh, the papillae is large and there is characteristic cobblestone appearance. The pH of tear is alkaline, while in trachoma it is acidic. The characteristic ropey discharge and absence of follicles and pannus will help to differentiate spring catarrh from trachoma. The treatment part of trachoma, the active trachoma constitute the TF and TI stage of WHO classification. It is mainly treated by use of antibiotic. either topical, systemic or combined use of antibiotic is being used. Topical therapy is by tetracycline 1% or erythromycin 1% eye ointments. The systemic is done by azithromycin 20 mg per kg body weight, maximum up to 1 gram. This is the first drug of choice. The combined can be done by both topical and systemic. In case of inactive trachoma, it constitutes the TS, TT and CO stages of WHO classification. The removal of concussions is done by hypodermic needles. In TT stage, the trichiasis is treated by permanent lash removal by electrolysis, cryolysis and radiofrequency epilations. Penetrating keratoplasty is indicated in case of significant corneal scarring. Keratoprosthesis is indicated in bilateral blind cases. Coming to the profile axis, according to WHO's GET 2020 program, SAFE strategy is used for the prophylaxis of trachoma. In SAFE, S stands for surgery, A for antibiotic, F for facial hygiene, and E stands for environmental changes.